Hi everyone, it's Emmett from Pi My Life Up. In this video, we'll be showing you how to set up a Cloudflare Tunnel on a Raspberry Pi. The Cloudflare Tunnel is a really neat piece of technology that allows you to route traffic from a device such as your Raspberry Pi to the internet without requiring a publicly routable IP address. It doesn't even require you to perform any port forwarding or open up any ports on your firewall. There's many use cases where this is incredibly useful. Many ISPs, for example, do not provide a static IP address, or they run you behind a CGNAT where one public IP address is used for multiple different devices. One of the best things about using a Cloudflare Tunnel is that it is incredibly easy to set up. With just a few short steps, you will soon have traffic routing through to your Raspberry Pi. For this example, we'll be using the Nginx web server. The only drawback to using the Cloudflare Tunnel is that you will require a domain name that is already routed through their network. We won't be walking you through this process, as Cloudflare does a pretty good job of it themselves. Once you are ready to proceed, open up the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH into it. Before we start setting up the Cloudflare Tunnel, let's ensure our operating system is up to date. Update the package list by typing in sudo apt update and then pressing enter. Next, upgrade any out of date packages by typing in sudo apt upgrade -y. Our next step is to install both the kel and lsb-release packages. We will be using these two tools to set up the official Cloudflare repository on your Raspberry Pi. Install these packages by typing in sudo apt install kel lsb-release space -y and then pressing enter. With all the tools now installed, we can begin adding the Cloudflare package repository to our Raspberry Pi. Adding this repository helps ensure that we install the latest available version of the Cloudflare daemon. This daemon is what is responsible for maintaining the connection through the Cloudflare tunnel. Save the GPG key for this repository by typing in kel space -, capital L space https://forward/pkg.cloudflare.com/cloudflare-main.gpg /pipe/sudo/t/user/keyrings/cloudflare-archive-keyring.gpg /greater-than/symbol/dev/null. The GPG key is basically a way for us to verify that the packages we are downloading from Cloudflare did in fact come from their repository and not some random middleman. Now you can add the Cloudflare repository itself by typing in echo space double quote deb space open square bracket signed -, by equal sign slash user slash share slash keyrings slash Cloudflare -archive -keyring.gpg close square bracket space https://cloudflare.com/cloudflare /$_open_lsb_release/-cs close bracket space main double quote space pipe symbol space sudo space t /etc/apt/sources.list.d/cloudflare.list. Now that we have added a new repository to our sources list, we will need to run an update of the package list again by typing in sudo apt update and pressing enter. If everything has worked properly so far, you should see that the Cloudflare repository is now referenced within the sources list. We can now install the Cloudflare daemon, which will manage our Cloudflare tunnel on our Raspberry Pi, by typing in sudo apt install cloudflared and then pressing enter. Now to set up the Cloudflare tunnel, we will need to associate it with your Cloudflare account. To begin this process, type in cloudflared space tunnel space login and then press enter. If you're using the desktop version of Raspberry Pi OS, the login page will be automatically opened within a web browser. Alternatively, you'll want to go to the link shown on your screen and follow the prompts to authorize the Cloudflare tunnel with a specific domain name. Once you have done this, the terminal will automatically update saying that it successfully logged in and has saved credentials for your account. we can now use the Cloudflare daemon to create a tunnel between our Raspberry Pi and the Cloudflare network. To create this tunnel, type in Cloudflare space tunnel space create space followed by a name for your tunnel, which for this example we will be calling ours Raspberry Pi tunnel. After running this command, you'll be greeted with a unique identifier that is used for your tunnel. Make a note of this ID, as you will need it later on within this guide. We can now begin routing traffic through this domain by typing in Cloudflare space tunnel space route space DNS space the name that you assign to your tunnel and then space again and then the domain name you want this traffic routed through. This domain name must contain the zone that you configured the tunnel to use, which in our case was pimylifeup.com. If everything has worked properly, you should see a message saying that it has successfully added a CNAME for your chosen domain name. Any traffic through this domain name will be automatically routed for your Cloudflare tunnel. However, at the moment, this tunnel will literally route to nothing. Let's route it to our Nginx server by typing in Cloudflare space tunnel space run space hyphen hyphen URL space localhost colon symbol 80 space followed by the name that we assigned our tunnel earlier. Once the tunnel has started, we can now open our favorite web browser and go to our chosen domain name, which in our case should be https colon symbol forward slash forward slash raspberry.pimylifeup.com. Here you can see that we have successfully routed traffic to our Raspberry Pi through the Cloudflare tunnel, as we have seen the Nginx default screen. The only problem with how we have set up the Cloudflare tunnel currently is that once our Raspberry Pi restarts, the tunnel and all our configuration will be lost. Luckily, the Cloudflare daemon allows us to easily set up a more permanent connection. Now, within the terminal, stop the current tunnel by pressing Ctrl plus C. Next, we can begin writing the config file that will set up our persistent Cloudflare tunnel connection on our Raspberry Pi by typing in sudo nano space tilde slash dot cloudflare slash config dot yml and then press enter. Start this file by typing in tunnel colon followed by a space and then a name for this Cloudflare tunnel. In our case, we'll use Raspberry Tunnel. Next, we will need to point this to the credentials file that was generated when we set up the Cloudflare tunnel earlier. To do this, type in credentials hyphen file colon space slash home slash followed by the name of your user, which in our case is Pi, followed by slash dot cloudflare slash and then the unique identifier that was generated when you set up the tunnel earlier. This will be a longish string with a couple of hyphens in it. Once you have typed it out, end this line with .json. Our next step is to define the ingress so that the Cloudflare daemon knows where to route traffic that is coming over the tunnel to our Raspberry Pi. Let us start by defining our first hostname by typing in space space hyphen space hostname colon symbol space followed by your domain name, which in our case is raspberry.pimylifeup.com. Next, we must specify a service that is running on this particular hostname. On a new line, type in service colon space and then http colon forward slash localhost colon symbol and then your port, which in our case is port 80. You can change this port to anything such as 8080, 8181, as long as the service is running on it using your specified protocol. Cloudflare does support different protocols and not just HTTP. We cover some of these within our written guide that you can find in the description below. However, HTTP and HTTPS are the only protocols that work without needing the client to run the Cloudflare tunnel software as well. Finally, this config file must always end with a declaration of a service that is used as a fallback. Anything that doesn't match the hostname above will be automatically redirected to this service. In our case, we're going to type in hyphen space service colon symbol space HTTP underline status colon 404. Essentially, any traffic that doesn't meet our hostname requirement will automatically be directed to a 404 page not found. Once you've finished filling out this file, save and quit by pressing Ctrl plus X and then Y and then enter. Config file now written, we'll need to save this and install it as a service by typing in sudo space cloudflare space hyphen hyphen config /tilde/.cloudflare/config.yml/service/install and then press enter. With the service now installed, we can ensure that it is set to automatically start at boot and start it immediately by typing in sudo systemctl enable /cloudflare /--now. Now verify that everything is working properly by going to your specified domain name in your favorite browser. In our case, we'll go to https://raspberry.pymylifeup.com. Here you can see that we can see the Nginx welcome screen. This indicates to us that we have successfully set up the Cloudflare Tunnel on our Raspberry Pi. If you like this guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.